I've always believed in you can have your cake and eat it too in this genre and in pop music, whatever that, you know, from Britney Spears all the way over to the Bird and the Bee. My friend's great, Kristen and Inara George. I mean,
amazing girl.
Yeah, and both are female singers. Both are competing essentially for the same airspace and sales. And both are in the kind of pop genre. Mm-hmm. Well, they both better have hooks. They both better have some kind of hooky lyrical content. Ideally, they have some rhythmic element that affects you. You may not want to get up and dance, but you're in your car tapping on the steering wheel. If a song presents all that stuff, all those components, ingredients, and whether it's the Burn the Bee song, the Britney Spears song, anything in between, if you are hooked in, mission accomplished. Mm-hmm. And I have nothing but respect for that. What I have trouble with, and what I try to keep as far away from my music as possible, not getting sucked into, is stuff that just, it's so easy to go through the rudimentary rote mechanics of songwriting. You gotta have this generic Radiohead chord progression of the moment, mm-hmm. or whatever flavor of the week's going on. The
four chords of doom, if or, you know,
exactly.
Whatever.
Yeah. This hip hop beat that the white community is now ripped off from the hip hop community, that's now, so you gotta have that installed.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that requires some intelligence and some talent and all that, but it's not, at the end of the day, if you haven't said anything, if there's no substance, if you haven't mm-hmm. moved the listener in some deep way. See, that's the thing. Any of us can pick up an instrument, learn songwriting basics, learn performance basics, and and you buy the handbook down at the music store, how to write a song, right?
Mm-hmm.
Once you've done that, then you got to go excavate what is it that sets Dylan aside from the other 1,000 guys that tried to be Dylan.
Mm-hmm.
What is it that sets Queen or any of your favorite bands? I mean, why is Big Star and Brian Wilson and ELO and all these different groups still heralded to this day? What grasp does Elvis Presley and the Sex Pistols still have on people 30 years later?
Mm-hmm.
That's what fascinated me.
Mm-hmm.
That's what made me want to sit for hours and do my homework and figure out what those ingredients were.
Mm-hmm.
And speak that language on my own terms.